So I was browsing over the internet trying to figure out what my next project will be. So I found this really cool looking stealth design of a boat.
This, ladies and gentlemen, is Ghost. Ghost is an original design by a guy named Greg Sankoff of Juliet Marine Systems. Ghost is designed to be a high-speed protection boat that was meant to be used by the United States Navy.
I know it looks really cool and futuristic, but that isn't what actually sparked my interest to work on this project.
But Ghost is a vessel known as a Swath, and Swath stands for Small Water Plane Area Twin Hull. Yeah, it's a mouthful. But basically, a Swath is a twin hull design that minimizes hull cross-sectional area at the ship's surface. So unlike conventional ships and boats' hulls, a Swath vessel hull basically is always fully submerged underwater, hence offering less drag, since less of the hull is exposed to be struck by oceanic waves. So because the hulls themselves are under the water surface, it makes it safer and easier for the ship to sail when high tides and fast currents hit with full force. Conventional boat hulls have more surface interacting with the water surface waves, and these receive huge wave impact, and drag is always an issue. But Ghost is designed with thin struts that literally cuts the waves, hence decreasing wave forces acting on the boat. Ghost is also designed to work as a hydrofoil of some sort. The cabin area is always above the water level, and this is made possible by the struts, which act as hydrofoils when the boat enters the high-speed configuration. I found this design very interesting, and I thought I should replicate it on a smaller scale and make my own design changes to try and see how it actually behaves in real life. The original Ghost design makes use of these propellers that are mounted on this submerged hulls and pulls the boat forward, actually giving the boat better efficiency through cavitation. So cavitation, in summary, is when you disturb a fluidic medium like water to create bubbles and then pass an object through those bubbles, which makes that object experience less drag since the bubbles are actually more viscous. But anyways, I thought of using submersible motors, but then that would prove to be a bit challenging and complex for a small RC model. So I decided I would power the boat using one of these electric ducted fans. Besides, I think my design looks cooler and unique. After creating my own CAD designs to something that looks like Ghost and incorporating these grid features to save on weight, it was time to 3D print everything.
So my radar working, and my motor.
So I started weighing all my parts to try and figure out if my craft is going to be buoyant or not, using the following calculations.
Now, if we want to see if any object can float on water or not, its density of that object has to be less than the density of water. So for our craft, to find the density, we need the mass, which we have already gotten. That the mass density, anyways, is mass over volume. So the density of our craft, it's the mass, which is 0.453 kilograms over the volume. Now we can get the volume on our CAD diagram. So if we look here, we find that the volume is in millimeters cubed. The density of our ship is 335.15. So our value for our ship is obviously less than the density of the water. So we are confident that our ship is going to float. If it sinks, it's simply because of other reasons, not because it's too heavy. So that is it.
When all this was done, I was prepared and ready and took a short journey to the nearest park, which had a lake, and my little brother escorted me.
All right, hi guys. We are here at Rhodes Park. It's a beautiful sunny day. And feeling really good. We are here with our stealth ship, the Ghost. Let's hope this thing doesn't sink. I have a few things that I'm not confident about today. First of all, I've done my calculations. It's gonna be buoyant according to my calculations. One thing that I'm not confident with is the waterproofing. I didn't do any waterproofing, so if this thing sinks, all my electronics are just gonna be damaged, and it's gonna be difficult recovering it from this lake. But anyways, and I'm gonna try putting a camera on it and see how that goes. The camera is not the best quality, so don't expect the best from that. So yeah, let's connect everything, put the electronics together, and we are going to test this thing out.
And this is where my main issues began. We can see that it was tipping over to the front as I was applying the thrust. So I took it out of the water and tried to balance the center of gravity by shifting the battery and the electronics. And it sort of worked, as you can see in this video here, as I was piloting it around. On the top right corner we have the onboard video camera, and it wasn't going so well. I wasn't putting a lot of thrust because it had a tendency of tipping over to the front, like nose diving sort of a thing. So after trying a few times to shift the center of gravity, I had a lot of issues. Sometimes it was tail heavy, sometimes it was nose heavy, and also water was getting inside. And in this video, you can still see I was trying to shift the center of gravity by shaking the electronics to put them more towards the front, but it still had issues. And finally, I got it to work, and it was sort of working, but then the thrust wasn't working so well. I think my batteries had run low, and this is where the worst happened. So it started sinking. I think the center of gravity shifted and then it started to sink. There's nothing I could do at this point but only watch. So after taking it out of the water, I actually jumped in there. Everything was drenched. That's a lot of water flowing out of there. And yeah, we had some spectators. Good old men.
So that's gonna be the end of the video. I will fix this guy. I think if it's balanced and I make it properly, it's gonna be so much fun. I'm gonna try to make a box where I will include all the electronics so that I can waterproof it. But I doubt it's gonna sink the next time because I already know why it sank. The center of gravity was not correct. I tried shifting the battery around, but that didn't work. It worked a little bit. It was so much fun, you know, controlling it around. The power was great, but the battery had run out as well. So there's gonna be a part two of this video where I do some updates on this thing, and then you wanna have fun watching now. Thank you so much. Till next time.